Hello, hello, my beautiful students. How are you today? Hope that you are pretty, pretty fine. Okay, my sweethearts. Today we are going to start, well, we are going to continue with certain things that are going to be very, very useful for you. Okay, because I remember that I was mentioning in the last class that we are not paying a lot of attention with grammatical tenses, but also we are paying more attention to some details that are going to be some parts of the speech. We are going to be having, for example, for today, too, enough, some differences that sometimes we use a lot, but we don't know how to use them enough. For that reason, let's go with this that I have here for you. Let me share with you my presentation. And let's start here. Excellent. Here we go. Well, very well. Welcome to your English class. Hope that you're having a wonderful, wonderful day, a wonderful, wonderful week. And I hope to see you soon in our classes. Okay, well, here we go. English class, welcome here. Hey there. Hello there. How are you? Hope that you're pretty, I hope that pretty fine. I'm so excited, sorry. Hello there. I hope that you're pretty fine. And welcome, 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 welcome to this English class. Let's learn something new every day. And for that reason, here we go. Let's continue with this. On your marks, raise it and go. Now we are going to start with a little bit of speaking, okay? And let's start working with this. Look at this. This is going to be an exercise for you, okay? We are not going to be playing with this in this moment because we are going to be having like 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12 minutes. Just you and I looking at us. What are you going to be doing? We are going to play this. You are going to spin the roulette. And you are going to stop the roulette whenever you want, okay? Stop it. And you are going to be having some questions that you need to answer in 2 minutes, not less than that time, okay? Remember that almost every single day we are going to be practicing speaking because in this level, it is one of the skills that we need to be using more and more and more every single day. For that reason, if you got this question, what would you do if fear was not a factor and you could not fail? Híjole, ¿qué harías si el temor, el miedo no fuera un factor determinante en ti, en tu vida y no pudieras fallar en lo que emprendes? No, and you are going to click on this, and oh my goodness, and you need to be speaking in English. Well, I think that if fear was not a factor, and I would be pretty sure that I cannot fail, I would dare to travel around the world. Doesn't matter if I don't have enough money because life is only one, and for that, okay. For 2 minutes, when you finish your 2 minutes, you do the same with another question, okay? Like, for example, stop. Well, if I were, I good. If I were, I don't know, if I were Shakira, I could be dancing. Ah, bueno, pero te regresas el medidor, ¿no? Y empiezas, if I were Shakira, I could be dancing every day in order to ta-ta-ta-ta-ta-ta-ta-ta for 2 minutes. But if you click on the roulette, and they are turning, 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 and you got, oh, I saw a new phone, un objeto volador no identificado. Pero si te queda en una que ya habías respondido, te la vuelves a aventar 2 minutos, pero con un contexto diferente, ¿ok? That is going to be what we are going to be doing. Oh my goodness. I know that maybe you are like this, like, what? Yes, I know. But I know that you can do it in a very, very good way. You need to practice your speaking. And if you want, you can record every single answer with and send me the message like, well, if I were the president, I would be trying to send, enviar. You can send that message to your server in order that you can be practicing your speaking with someone else, okay? Try to go out to that zone, that easy zone, and now we are going to be trying new exercises in order that you can be practicing your speaking, okay? But now, guess who is going to be teaching you some things? Of course, I am going to be asking you some questions. Here you are going to be certain situations, but you need to speak in English for at least 1 minute, answering all these questions that I have here for you, because I have heard some students that ask, oh, I want to practice, but I don't have a topic. I don't know what to talk about. Ah, well, don't worry. Here you are going to be having all these topics that are going to be very useful for you. Actually, we were talking about this. When was the last time that you ate an ice cream? You got it. How can someone become famous? You got it. What was the last, the name of the last song you listened to? When do you plan usually, when do you usually plan your summer holiday? What's your favorite day of the week? When do you feel you are more productive? You already know all those. But now you are going to be having all these new questions, okay? As we were practicing with this, now we are going to be practicing with this again, but at least for 1 minute. You are not going to be answering this question as simply, no. You need to add as much information as you can. And for example, we are going to have, do you know anyone living in France? No, I don't, but I think that if I could be able to tag it, tag it, tag it, tag it, tag it, tag it, for 1 minute. Oh, will you vote in the next elections? Well, I don't really like politics because it is easy to start a business in this country. Oh, well, thank you for asking. Well, in my opinion, I can say that. Imagine that you are speaking, somebody asked these questions to you, and you need to be answering them as normal as you can, as significant as you can, as colloquial as you can, okay? Pretend that you are just chatting with someone else and that you are having this kind of conversations. You need to sound very natural, okay? In this way, we are going to be practicing or speaking, as I was telling you. What do you usually do when you want to learn new words in English? What European countries would you like to visit? What European countries would you like to visit? Would you like to work abroad? Would you like to work abroad? That's going to be cool. What do you think? At least you need to be speaking for 6 minutes, okay? Ay, very good, my sweethearts. Those were some tips in order that you can be having some tools to practice this amazing skill that I know that you have, but that we need to be working with every day. Well, now let's have another situation for you. You are a super agent. Use your imagination. You are a super agent. Tell us about you. I don't know what a super agent does. Look for it. I know that you can. Use your imagination. Let's have a different activity in order that you can be practicing. You're a super agent. Tell us about you. Well, I am 007. Ah, no. There's another one. I am 007.5, and I work for the Mexican government. I think that my job is very difficult because at least for 2 minutes, okay? This activity is going to be for 2 minutes. But now, guys, why are you doing this to me? You are making me suffer. No, it is because I love you, because it is important that you can be practicing this skill. Because one day you are going to be having a job interview, or you are going to be waiting for someone in a bench of a park, and maybe a native speaker is going to be it's going to get closer, and he or she is going to start talking with you, and you are going to be feeling very nervous because you are not practicing. We are trying to avoid all those situations in the future and more, okay? For that reason is that we are doing this. Well, girls and boys, let's talk about Christmas. And I got some questions for you. Chan, 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 chan. Tell me, sweetheart, what's your favorite Christmas food? Turkey. Okay. You can answer as you want. Do you have any Christmas traditions? Do you have any Christmas tradition? Okay. Do you like Christmas music? Do you like Christmas music? When do you open your Christmas presents? Tell me. When do you open your Christmas presents? Okay. Who decorates your house, or who decorates your Christmas tree? Okay. What do you do on Christmas Eve? I mean, 24th December. What do you do on Christmas Eve? I mean, 24th December. Ay, mi alergia. Okay, you are practicing your speaking little by little. Very well. Oh, and maybe it was like, oh my goodness, in my family we used to, or I used to do, oh, maybe you are thinking more in English because we were having the previous activities. That could be great. But now let's go here. Oh my God, what are we going to be having? I'm afraid, I'm a kind of afraid. No, come on, don't be afraid. This is going to be fun. So we are going to start a little bit with this. Christmas rhymes. And we are going to be practicing with this. Okay, guys. Something you sent to say Merry Christmas that rhymes with yard. Something you sent to say Merry Christmas that rhymes with yard. I know that you can do it. I know that you can do it. Okay. You are going to be sending a card. You are going to send a card. Well, something Santa gives you that rhymes with lift. We are practicing vocabulary. Something Santa gives you that rhymes with lift. Gift. This is a gift. This is a gift. Something Santa holds that rhymes with back. Something Santa holds that rhymes with back. It's a sack. It's a sack. Very well. Something Santa drives that rhymes with day. Something Santa drives that rhymes with day. Something Santa drives that rhymes with day. Slate, slate, slate. When Santa got stuck on the chimney, he began to shout, "This is a sleigh." Ay Dios, a Santa's or a Santa's reindeer that rhymes with wolf. A Santa's reindeer that rhymes with wolf. A Santa's reindeer that rhymes with wall. Rudolph! Oh, wolf. That rhymes with wolf, Rudolph. Okay. Someone who helps Santa that rhymes with shelf. Someone who helps Santa, that rhymes with shelf. Elf. It is going to be an elf. Ooh. Something people sing at Christmas that rhymes with barrel. Something people sing at Christmas that rhymes with barrel. Carols. The carols. And the one who sings the carols are the carolers, the carols. We wish you a Merry Christmas. We wish you a Merry Christmas. We wish you a Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year. Okay, very well. Let's go with this. Something green you decorate that rhymes with sea. Something green you decorate that rhymes with sea. What could it be? Ah, it's going to be the tree, the Christmas tree. Ah. Something you put on the top of the tree that rhymes with guitar. Something you put on the top of the tree that rhymes with guitar. The star. It is going to be a star. Something you put on the door that rhymes with red. Red, leile, rojo. Something you put on the door that rhymes with red. The crypt. This is going to be a crypt. Do you used to have some rats on your door? Okay. A Christmas ornament that rhymes with lolly. A Christmas ornament that rhymes with lolly. Holly. This is going to be, or these are going to be, the hollies. Something you hang by the fireplace that rhymes with rocking. Something you hang by the fireplace that rhymes with rocking. What could it be? Excellent, stocking. They are going to be the stocking. Or here's something you light that rhymes with handle. Something you light that rhymes with handle. Candle. Candle, excellent. Candle. Something Santa rings that rhymes with well. Something Santa rings that rhymes with well. The bell, the bell. Something sweet that rhymes with lane. Something sweet that rhymes with lane. What could it be? Candy cane, candy cane. Something people put on the roof that rhymes with nights. I know that you can do it. The lights, the lights. Excellent, excellent. Excellent, excellent. Or here, Merry, Merry Christmas. Merry, Merry Christmas. Very, Merry Christmas. Excellent, excellent. Excellent, excellent. Very, very good. What do you think? Easy or difficult? Not so easy, not so difficult. That's cool. Now you know a little bit more about Christmas. And that's cool. And that's great. Do you like Christmas time? Excel, excel, excellent. Excel, excel, excellent. Very, very, very good. But now, let's go with this that I have here for you. Preparadísimos. Bueno. The time is now. Oh my goodness, really? No, por favor. Regresemos a nuestro vocabulario. Estaba tan cute. Ya hasta se ríe el Santa Claus. Go, 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 go. No. It is time to continue with this. The time is now. Oh, really? Yes. I remember that during the last class, we were talking about correlative conjunctions. And we were mentioning that correlative conjunctions are two separated conjunctions that are often in sentences together, okay? We are going to be having different kind of correlative conjunctions, but and. Correlative conjunctions means that they are going to be two conjunctions that are going to be working together. Excellent. That's a situation that we are going to be having. What do you think about this? Conjunctions or the word conjunction means that there is only one word that is going to be joining or matching an idea or a sentence. Correlative conjunction means that two conjunctions are going to be working together in the same sentence. That's why we have been talking about correlative conjunctions. I remember that we started with conjunctions. And now, we are talking about correlative conjunctions. As I was telling you, a conjunction is one word that is going to be working isolated, but correlative conjunctions are going to be two conjunctions because the main point of the conjunction is to join, to match sentences, ideas, words. But when they work together, the name for these two is going to be correlative conjunctions. And here we have some examples of these correlative conjunctions. Both Maroon and Gracie accent nicely. Both Maroon and Gray accent nicely. Either or, I like to wear either pants or capris. Neither nor, neither the shirt nor the jacket fit. Not only but, or not only but also, not only one bottom fell off, but all of them. Oh, not only one bottom fell off, but also all of them. We can be using not only, but also, or not only but. Actually, we are going to be talking about but. Ooh. Whether or. We were talking about this. Whether or not you wear nice clothes, you have to wear clothes. Ya sea o no que uses ropa bonita, tienes que vestirte, tienes que usar ropa. Not so much as, and we are going to be having a lot of correlative conjunctions. Yes, don't worry, we are going to be having a class where we are going to be having all these correlatives in order that you can be learning more about this because these are going to be very useful for you. Correlatives, conjunctions. It was not that these clothes were flamboyant so much as they were florid. Hey, it was not that his clothes were flamboyant. No, no fue que sus ropas fueran flamboyantes so much as they were flores. Tanto como estaban floreadas. No es que estuviera tan flamboyante, tanto como estaba florido. They were florid. And here you are going to be having more hardly when, such that, neither nor whether or as is a comparative, rather than scarcely when, both and, not only but also, either or, so as, no sooner than, the more, so that. This is what we are going to be learning also, so don't get desperate. We are going to be working a lot with this. You are going to be learning each one of these, but little by little, okay? Well, you are going to be having this material for you. But now we are going to start with other ones that we are going to be using so much. Either, neither, or either. But as you can see, so and to are in the middle. And these are some words that we are going to be using. So and to, what's the difference? Have you ever thought about the differences between these two words? Do you remember the meaning of these two words? So is for, oh my goodness, this soup is so hot. Oh my goodness, this soup is too hot. Yes, they are going to be intensifiers. Yes. But at the same time, we are going to be using all these words in a different way because we are going to start agreeing. So and to are used to show agreement with positive statements said by person A, I mean by the first person that is talking. And we are talking about so and to because during the last classes, we were talking about neither or either in order to agree. Well, let me tell you that so and to are going to be intensifiers in order to say, oh, this is so hot. This is too hot. Ah, but also, So and to are going to be having an extra meaning, and you are going to be using so and to in order to show agreement to something that a person is mentioning or saying. For example, person A is the one that is talking, no? I am happy. So am I. You are making a noise. So are you. I need more money. So do I. Steve likes pizza. So does Mary. I was tired this morning. So was I. We were late. So were they. I watched a movie last night. So did I. She can play the guitar, so can I. We could see the stars, so could I. She will win an award, so will I. I would like a cup of coffee, so could I, so could you, so could him. He should study more. So should I, so should you, so should she. They have finished early. So have I, so has he, so has it, so has my mother, so has we. He had eaten too much. So had I, so had you, so had my family, so had my father, so had my husband. Do you remember that we have been talking about this? We were talking about all these in previous classes, but we were having an example, a very near example, that it was with neither, yo tampoco. The other one was for disagreeing. Era para no estar de acuerdo. Era para mostrar desacuerdo. Aquí lo que tú ya estás haciendo es mostrar que estás de acuerdo. Es el famoso yo también. El soy y el tú van a servirte para decir yo también. I am happy. So am I. Estoy feliz. Yo también lo estoy. Ese so va a ser un tipo también. Yo también. Y va a pasar lo mismo. Si estoy hablando en presente simple con el verbo to be, tengo que responder en presente simple con el verbo to be. You're making a noise. So are you. Tú estás haciendo un ruido. Tú también. Tú también lo estás haciendo. Verbo to be en presente progresivo. Ah, pues respondo en presente progresivo. No siempre con so are you. So are you. Puede ser el sujeto que quiera. So are my sisters. So are you. So is he, solamente vas a tener cuidado con los verbos. I need more money. So do I. Necesito más dinero. So do I. Yo también. ¿Sale? Presente simple. Respondo con presente simple. Me guío de los auxiliares de cada tiempo y de la conjugación de esos auxiliares con ciertas personas. El auxiliar del tiempo del que estamos hablando tiene que encajar con la persona que está respondiendo, de la que está diciendo yo también, él también. Tips like pizza, so does Mary. A Steve le gustan las pizzas, a Mary también. Oye, como está hablando de Steve, ¿tuve que usar una tercera persona? No, puedes decir so do I, so do we, so do they, a ellos también, a nosotros también. Y no solo I, you, she, he, so does Mary, también a Mary. I was tired this morning, so was I. Estaba cansada esta mañana, so was I. Yo también lo estaba. Estoy hablando en pasado simple con el auxiliar del verbo to be. Tengo que responder en pasado simple con el auxiliar del verbo to be. We were late, so were we. También nosotros. Pasado con el verbo to be, respondo con mi pasado con el verbo to be. No porque sea verbo to be, no respondo con el mismo verbo, respondo con el mismo auxiliar. Que hay muchos que son verbo y auxiliar, qué padrísimo, ¿no? Ya no te tienes que preocupar. La cuestión es cuando tienes los verbos, los tiempos simples, presente simple, pasado simple, ¿no? Que usan los auxiliares como do, does, did. Aquí, por ejemplo, I watched a movie last night, so did I. Estoy hablando en pasado simple, entonces mi auxiliar para responder va a ser el auxiliar del pasado simple. She can play the guitar, so can I. Ella puede tocar la guitarra, yo también. Estoy hablando en presente simple, pero mi auxiliar es el can, que cabe la casualidad que es verbo y es auxiliar. Entonces, so can I, so can you, so can she, so can he. No lleva ese, no le pones ese, esos auxiliares. He could see the stars, so could I. Él podía ver las estrellas, yo también podía, yo también. Ya no repites yo también podía, yo también puedo, yo también quiero, yo también soy, yo también estoy, yo también. Al momento en que tú ya vas a estar haciendo uso de tu auxiliar, automáticamente ya se sobreentiende que tú también puedes, tú también estabas, tú también eres, tú también tienes. She will win an award. So will I, so will she, so will my family. Ella ganará un award. Yo también, un premio, un reconocimiento. Yo también. Ya no decimos yo también lo haré. O lo lograré, o lo tendré, o recibiré. Con el so will I, ya queda por sentado, ¿no? Que lo mismo que esa persona está diciendo u obteniendo es lo mismo para ti. I would like a cup of coffee. I would, so would I. A mí también. Me gustaría una tacita de café. A mí también. So would I. ¿Cuál es el auxiliar? Estoy hablando con good. Pues mi auxiliar del tiempo es good. He should study more, so should I. Él debería estudiar más. Yo también. ¿Yo también qué? Yo también debería estudiar más. Y como estoy usando el should, que es el auxiliar de ese tiempo, no, utilizo ese mismo auxiliar. They have finished early, so have I. Ellos han terminado temprano. Yo también que yo también he terminado temprano. Ellos también, nosotros también, ella también, so has she. Puedes jugar con el auxiliar, no porque aquí tiene have o fuerzas vas a responder siempre con have. Depende quién es la persona que está diciendo también. He had eaten too much, so had I. Él había comido mucho. Yo también, so had I. Yo también, ¿qué? Yo también había. ¿Qué cosa? Comido mucho, ¿no? But let me tell you that this is one way. The auxiliary verb to be, the auxiliary verb or to be or to have needs to agree with the verb tense in the original statement. Verb to be or verb have are going to be used here in the original sentence as each one of these, depending the auxiliary verb is how you are going to be answering with that auxiliary verb. Let me tell you that we are going to be having other situation. Si no quieres decir so am I, yo también, lo volteas, como cuando teníamos el neither y el either. I am happy too. Esta es la respuesta corta, por así decirla, pequeña. So am I, so are you, so do I. Solamente hay que practicarle para ver en qué tiempo están hablando y tú luego, luego, mostrar que estás de acuerdo también, o sea, que tú también, que a ti también te pasa, que tú también quieres, que tú también sientes eso, que tú también, que a ti también, pero en el tiempo correspondiente. But we can have another way. The long way. I am happy too. I am happy too. You are making a noise. You are making a noise too. Aquí tú ya eres más específico. Estoy feliz. Estoy feliz también. O también estoy feliz. You are making a noise. You are making a noise too. Estás haciendo un ruido. Estás haciendo un ruido también. O también estás haciendo un ruido. Aquí tú ya estás siendo mucho más específico y específica. Aquí en esta respuesta se da por sentado lo que pasa, aquí no. Tú ya estás como reforzando, ¿no? Enfatizando lo que se dijo. Y es más largo. I need more money. I need more money too. Necesito más dinero. Yo necesito también más dinero. Steve likes pizza. Mary likes pizza too. A Mary le gusta también la pizza. We were late. They were late too. Oh, llegamos tarde. Ellos llegaron tarde también. They were late too. Puedes ir cambiando dependiendo de la persona que esté también diciendo también. No, no tiene que ser we were late too. O I was late too. No, no, no. Si ellos, si tú, si nosotros, si ella, si Luis, si Juan, si Pedro, si el compadre, están diciendo también, ese es hacia el sujeto. Y aquí ya no hay pierde porque es lo mismo, solo con el to, porque estás enfatizando, estás reforzando lo mencionado. I watched a movie last night. I watched a movie too. Vi una noche ayer, yo también vi una película. Obvio no le vas a poner, I watched a movie last night too. No tiene que ser todo, 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 completísimo, igualísimo. I can play the guitar. I can play the guitar too. We could see the stars. I could see the stars too. She could see the stars too. My mom can see the stars. Could see the stars too. I will win an award. I will an award. I will win an award too. Ganaré un premio. Yo también ganaré un premio. No sé si ya te estás dando cuenta cuando lo uso más. Yo me casaré en Cancún. Yo me casaré en Cancún también. Ah, una cosa es decir, yo también, a decir, yo también me casaré en Cancún. You are emphasizing. I would like a cup of coffee. I would like a cup of coffee too. Me gustaría una taza de café. A mí también me gustaría una taza de café. O me gustaría una taza de café también. Penny. He should study more. I should study more too. Él debería estudiar más. Yo debería estudiar más también. Luis debería estudiar más también. O también debería estudiar más, as you want to translate it, ¿no? We had eaten too much. I had eaten too much too. This is the difference that we are going to be having with this. Let me tell you that sometimes you can use so the auxiliary and the verb as a continuation of the first part of the sentence. John can sing well, and so can his brother. Puedes hacer oraciones también, no tienes que esperar que la persona hable para que digas tú también, o yo también. No tienes que esperar que alguien diga algo para que tú puedas mostrar que estás de acuerdo o mostrar que alguien está de acuerdo. Puedes hacer oraciones con esto. John can swim well and so can his brother. John puede cantar bien y también su hermano. No estoy esperando que alguien me hable, sino que algo de lo que yo estoy expresando estoy continuando con algo o alguien más. I can eat 10 burgers. And my brother, so can my brother. And so can my brother. Y también mi hermano. So can my brother. Oh. Or you can use two. John can sing well. And his brother can sing well too. Siempre que quieras usar el so, él va primero, después sujeto. Perdóname, auxiliar y sujeto. Es la respuesta corta, donde inmersamente ya está todo lo que dice la oración. O el to lo vas a estar utilizando cuando ya estás dando mucha más información o repitiendo la misma información de la que habla. John can sing well and so can his brother. John can sing well and his brother can sing well too. Solo que este to va al final. John puede cantar bien y también su hermano. Y también, ¿qué cosa su hermano? Cantar. Con el to, John can sing well and his brother can sing well too. John puede cantar bien y su hermano puede cantar bien también. Y su hermano puede también cantar bien. As you wish. That is the beginning of the topics that we are going to be having because as you can see, this is going to be pretty interesting. So to neither either. I like Japanese food a lot. So do I. I do too. Or I like Japanese food too. I'm crazy about dessert. Dessert, sorry, not dessert. Dessert. I'm crazy about dessert. So am I. I am too, or I am crazy too, or I am crazy about the dessert too. I can eat spicy food. So can I. I can too, or I can eat spicy food too. Aquí te cuento una salvadota, si quieres usar el to, pero no quieres repetir toda la misma información. Juega con los auxiliares del tiempo. Los auxiliares de los tiempos de los que estén hablando son tu salvación. ¿Sale? Aquí ya no quieres enfatizar si te usas el I can too, I am too, I did too. Ya no estás enfatizando tanto el volver a decir, a mí también me encanta, yo también corro en el parque. No, estás, so can I can too. So can I can too. También yo, dos formas de decir, ambas son igual de usadas. No te me estreses ni preocupes de cuál es la mejor. All of them are the best. I don't like greasy food. Neither do I. I don't either. I'm not in the mood for Indian food. Neither am I. I am not either. I'm not in the mood es no tengo ganas, ¿no? I'm not in the mood. I'm not in the mood. No tengo ganas. I'm not in the mood. ¿Cómo lo vas viendo? Easy, right? I can't stand fast food. No puedo tolerar la comida rápida. Neither can I. I can't either. This is what we were talking about during some past classes. So, Can you see how we are going to be using neither, either, when you are agreeing or disagreeing? Because remember that if you are comparing or you are joining two situations, so and to, neither and either are going to be working as correlative conjunctions most of the times. But isolated, alone, they are going to be having other meanings and other ways in which they are going to be used. Okay. But also, let me tell you that we are going to be having these situations. What's the difference to and so? Ah, this is the other side of the coin. To means more. More than enough. More than needed. More than necessary. Y es que aquí ya no está como correlative conjunction. Para decir también. Aquí ya está como demasiado. Vamos a ver ambos significados también, sí. No solo un significado, porque puede ser que ya se nos haya olvidado tantito el otro significado, ¿no? Two, he drives too fast. Él maneja demasiado rápido. He drives too fast. Aquí ya no estás usando el too como también, sino como demasiado. Aquí la forma de intensifier que habíamos comentado. He drives too fast. ¿Sale? Too fast. Y va antes de un adjetivo o de un adverbio. Porque acuérdate que un adjetivo describe cómo es algo y el adverbio describe cómo hace las cosas el verbo. So, makes an adjective or adverb stronger. ¿Sale? El to significa más que suficiente. Demasiado. El so hace mucho más fuerte el adjetivo o el adverbio. Your dog is so cute. Tu dog es lindísimo, fuertísimo, hermosísimo, so cute, hermosísimo. Incorrect, he's so cute dog. No, nunca. Este va pegado al adjetivo o el adverbio para volverlo. Lindísimo, padrísimo, hermosísimo, preciosísimo, carísimo, por cierto. Baratísimo, so cute, so fast, so strong. Van en la misma posición ambos, nada más que si te das cuenta, tienen usos diferentes. Exceptions include too funny and too kind because they are positive. What do you think about this? Actually, this is what we are going to be having. ¡Ay! Hoy que me quise peinar bonita, no quedó. This is what we are going to be having in order to continue learning and practicing the peculiarities of the language. What do you think? Interesting or not so much? Yes, right. Little by little, you are going to be learning a lot of situations. And as we were mentioning, we are not talking about grammatical tenses. No, we are talking about the real use of the language. And as you can see, in the real use of the language, we have different words that we use a lot and that maybe we know how to use them, or maybe we don't. That's the reason why we are working with this, in order that all those tiny, tiny things that we use every single day can have a real and a good use. What questions or what situations do you have? No? If you have any question or any situation, let me know and I'm going to be helping you. I'm going to stop with this in this moment, but we are going to continue with more, okay? So don't worry. Have a wonderful day, and I will see you soon. Bye-bye.